Yes, sir. We're officially back at it. Book Nice coming at you with the Marvel Legends Stiltman Build-A-Figure Wave Frogman Figure Review. Let's do it.
This ain't for no scalper. You a scalper? Then fuck out shit. This one for them real collectors. That's army building and posing figures. Marvel Legends. Imports. Mini Mafia I'm fucking with. Hype beast we know about you. Stay buying figs, don't know about me.
Six figures in the wave, you're going to need all six figures to complete the Stiltman Build-A-Figure. And a quick look at the artwork on the side of the box. It is the same on the left and the right flat. Alright, let's bust this bad boy open and see what's what. Alright, here we go. Eugene Petilio, aka Frogman. His bio on the back of the package reads, Eugene Petilio suits up as Frogman in a misguided attempt to restore his family's good name. Frogman's packed in with the left arm, an additional fist, and a gun to complete the Stiltman Build-A-Figure. And I know a lot of people probably thought initially that Frogman was a villain, but it was actually his father who was a villain, and he tried to redeem his family's name by going out and being a hero. And he was actually able to team up with some premier heroes like Spider-Man, and at one point he actually even helped Spider-Man defeat White Rabbit. He's even had a team up with Captain America. So a kind of silly, sort of goofy, C, D-list character, but a character we've never received before in figure form, and a great reuse of the Doc Ock Buck. I myself have been wondering when they'll be able to reuse this buck and who they might reuse it for. This definitely wasn't one of the first characters I thought about, but I do think it makes perfect sense. Out of the package, he has one open hand with the fingers slightly spread on the right arm and one fist on the left, but he does have interchangeable hands where you can go two fists or two open hands. And I was actually looking over old comic scans in which Frogman appeared, and he actually helped Spider-Man defeat Speed Demon in one of his first appearances, I think on accident too. Again, he's kind of goofy. The look of the costume is basically a classic look. There's been a few variations, few different iterations of the costume, but this is more of a classic look. I like it. I think it looks true to form, looks good in comparison to his comic book counterpart. I think the only thing that I would have preferred is if the texture of the suit was sort of like scaly, almost like a frog. I don't know that was really necessary. I still do think they did a pretty good job. I especially like what they did with this head sculpt, as far as you seeing him under the mask, sort of, or seeing his eyes underneath the mask through the mouth of the mask. It would have been cool if there was another head sculpt that had maybe the eyes open wider on the inside, or if they gave us an unmasked head, because we have seen him unmasked in the comic books. Should probably mention too that later on, or more recently, he was actually part of the 50 State Initiative as part of one of those teams. I really like the initiative and that idea of government sanctioned teams for each of the 50 states. I thought that was actually a really cool idea at some point. There's a look at the bottom of his foot. Now that I'm thinking about it, it would have been cool if we had like an interchangeable part to make this spring appear longer, just for more playability. I'm not sure about this backpack here, but if you see, there's a peg right there that's supposed to plug into that peg hole on the back. I'm not 100% sure if you can remove this. I was trying to see if this latch would come off, but I didn't want to tear it off and then not be able to get it back on. I'm gonna have to play with this a little bit more. Maybe once I get another one, or one of you guys in the comments could let me know if somebody has removed this backpack. Well, like I said, the deco looks pretty good. You can actually pop the head off, so if you are able to finesse an unmasked custom head and put it on there, then that is an option. But as you saw, the head is on a ball joint. Takes a little bit of pressure, but you can get the head down just about that far, and you can shift it back a little bit, turn it left to right, a little bit of pivot. Would have been nice if it was a better range of motion, but considering how kind of clunky and awkward this costume is, I think it actually works pretty well as it probably would work in real life. Shoulders on a ball joint, they're gonna come up just that far. You can do a full 360. There's an upper bicep swivel, double jointed elbow swivel, and a hinge on the wrist. No rotation. Actually, you do get rotation here at the wrist. No, you don't. It looks like a cut there, but you don't. So the upper torso articulation will go up and down, side to side, left and right. There is no waist articulation. T-joint at the pelvis, legs will come up that far. You do get a really good split. Upper thigh swivel, you do get a double jointed knee. There is rotation at the upper boot or upper fin or whatever you want to call that there. And you do get a hinge on the foot. You got to kind of shift this foot in order to hinge it back and forward, but it's there and it is a nice deep ankle pivot as well. So decent articulation. Like I said, they picked a perfect buck, I believe, for this guy reusing the Doc Ock mold. And here we go. One quick size comparison and I'm going to get up out of here. I just want to kind of finish off the reviews for the figures from this wave so I can get to Stiltman, wrap this up. On the far left, we have the White Rabbit figure, which is actually a pretty cool kind of slept on C-D-list character figure as well. I've seen a lot of people kitbash this figure to other things, especially because she has a lot of skin showing. You could take the jacket off and swap out the arms and do some different things with Mary Jane and other female characters. So pretty cool, but as is, she is a pretty comic accurate depiction of that character. And the retro carded Spider-Man, pretty cool how they were able to include Frogman in this wave and stick him in there and give us a character we've never had before in figure form. And then we got Speed Demon and Shocker. So two of the characters from the Superior Foes of Spider-Man. We still missing Overdrive to complete that team. Hopefully that'll get done this year sometime. But yeah, Frogman is one I would recommend, especially if you're a completist like me. You know, I'd like to get as many characters as possible in figure form from the Marvel Universe. So I never pass up on characters that have never been done in the line. And you're going to need this guy if you want to complete the Stiltman Build-A-Figure. So it is one I would recommend. Fun, a lot of playability with this guy, a lot of little comedic style displays and things you can do. It's actually not a bad figure overall. So thanks for hanging out. As always, rate, comment, and subscribe. Hit that bell down there. And until next time, peace. Grand champ and I raised more hell than the Sorrel. See you at the keyhole, fussing at the doorbell. Thought I wasn't coming without mine. You can put me on the front line, cause you doubt mine.